Preview. Hello guys and welcome to the basic learning. Now this is the part 4th of our chapter compound interest. So this chapter is related to the compound interest and we are doing the questions related to here using formula on half yearly basis. In the previous video I have told you the using formula on yearly basis. Now here I am going to tell you the questions related to doing the questions using formula on half yearly basis. So the formula was A equal P bracket 1 plus R upon 100 to the power N. This was the formula which we were using on yearly basis. Okay, now we are doing the question related to half yearly basis and the formula is A equal P bracket 1 plus R upon 200 to the power 2N. Now you can see the difference, clearly the difference between the yearly basis and half yearly basis. On yearly basis we were having a formula A equal P bracket 1 plus R upon 100 to the power N. Now the formula for yearly basis is A equal P bracket 1 plus R upon 200 to the power 2N. Now we are multiplying the number of years, the duration of time into 2. Okay, so I will give you an example. Suppose the principal is rupees 100 and the rate of interest is 10% and the time duration is 2 years. Or you can take it 1 year. Okay, so we will apply this formula here. A equal principal is 100, 1 plus rate is 10 upon 200 to the power 2 into 1. This is 1. Why? Because the duration of time in the question is 1 year and we are multiplying it with 2. So amount equal, you can reduce the zeros, 0 cancelled by 0. Here taking the LCM, 20 ones are 20 plus 1, that is 21. 21 upon 20. Here 2 ones are 2. When we are multiplying 2 into 1, that is gives 2. Okay. Now here we can reduce the 0 from 0 or we can multiply it. Amount equal 100 into the square of 21 is 441 and 20 is 400. Now you can reduce the 0 from zeros and divide 441 divide 441 from 4. 441 divided by 4. 4 ones are 4. Carrying 4. 4 ones are 4. 1. Now here many of the students do the mistake that they put the decimal over here and carry 0 over here. But this is wrong. Here we have to put 0. Because the answer we cannot get in 11 point something. So here 4 zeros are 0. Okay, now 1 left. Now you can put decimal easily and carry 0 over here. 4 2s are 8. 2 point is here, means decimal is here. So we can carry 0 also. 2 5s are 20. Sorry, 4 5s are 20. So we get 110.25. This is the amount. If in the question it is also asked to calculate the compound interest, then you can apply that formula, that compound interest equal final amount minus original principal. Our final amount is 110.25 minus rupees 100. So now we are left with 10.25. It is 10 rupees 25 paise. This is the compound interest and amount which we get, that is 110.25. I hope this example is clear to you. Now I will take one question related to this part. Now I will take another question. Suppose the principal is 10,000, rate is 20%, and the time duration is, you can take 2 years. Okay. So, the formula which we are going to apply on half yearly basis, that I have told you previously, A equal P bracket 1 plus R upon 200 to the power 2N. So, let's begin with the question. Principal is 10,000, bracket 1 plus rate is 20 upon 200, and the time duration is 2 into 2. The number of time is, years are 2, and the formula says 2 into N. That means number of years are 2 and 2 we are multiplying with number of years. So it gives 4. 10,000, 0 reduced by 0, 20 ones are 20, taking the LCM, 20 ones are 20, and plus 2, it gives 22, or you can divide it, 2 ones are 2, 2 ones are 2, 0 is 0, here comes 11 upon 10. Okay, 4 times, amount equal 10,000 into 11 upon 10 into 11 upon 10, 11 upon 10 into 11 upon 10. 4 times we are multiplying it because here 4 is given, the duration of time. 0 reduced by 0. Okay. Now you can multiply this. Okay. 11 into 11 into 11 into 11. That is 121 into 121. We get the answer, that is amount 14641, that is 14,641 rupees. Now for calculating the compound interest also, you can apply the formula, compound interest equal final amount minus original principal. Final amount is 14,641 minus rupees 10,000. Okay, so you can reduce it. This is 14,000 and this is 10,000. So you get 4,641 rupees. This is the compound interest that we get. And this is the amount. Okay, so I hope this question is quite clear to you. If you like the video, please hit the like button, share the video, subscribe our channel, and hit the bell icon to get more latest updates. Thanks for watching.